In this video, we can discuss sixth module. So in sixth module, there are mainly three topics, three systems of tests: text editors, interactive debugging system, and device drivers. We can discuss the text editors: introduction, overview of the editing process, user interface, and the editor structure. Text editors or editors are system software which enable the user to create and edit text files. For example, in C programming, we will use the Turbo C editor or Turbo C++ editor. Then other text editors in the operating system are Notepad, WordPad, etc. In Linux, we have VA editor. Then for emails also, we are having the editors. We all are familiar with the editors. So editors means we can type some data into it. So this data can be computer programs, or it can be a simple text, or equations, or tables, diagrams, line art, or photographs. But here in this module, we will be learning only text editors, which means it will contain only character strings are the primary elements of the target text. So the document editing process is an interactive user-computer dialogue designed to accomplish four tasks. So these are the four tasks. So first, from the target document, from the document, we had to select the part to be viewed or manipulated. Then determine how to format this view. For example, from a Word document, I am selecting one paragraph that is to be viewed, and I can format that paragraph in the second step, that is to format that paragraph. Format means I can change into italics, bold, or change the font size, etc. Then specify and execute the operations that modify the target document. That means I make that modification to the document. Then update. Update means save. Save the view appropriately. These are the editing steps. So first step is the traveling, which means traveling through the or going through the entire document to find out the area of interest. This can be done using the operations next screenful, or going to the bottom, or find a particular pattern, etc. So that is the first step, traveling through the document. And second step is filtering. Filtering means selecting what is to be viewed. So we are selecting some part of the document which is to be viewed on the screen. The next one is a formatting. Formatting means how this result of filtering will be seen on display screen. That is, the part to be viewed, we can do some formatting. Then editing. Editing means inserting, deleting, replacing, move, copy, cut, paste. These are the processes in the editing. There are two types of editors: manuscript-oriented editor and program-oriented editor. Manuscript-oriented editor means that editor is associated with characters, words, lines, sentences, and paragraphs. For example, in MS Word document, in that we'll consider each character, word, line, sentences. But program oriented editors, that is used for entering a program in a particular programming language. So in that, it is associated with identifiers, keywords, statements, etc. Coming to the user interface. So user interface means how a user is interacting with the editor. So there is a conceptual model for this. This conceptual model, in essence, provides an easily understood abstract of the target document and its elements with a set of rules describing the effect of operations on these elements. Other than this conceptual model, the user interface is concerned with mainly three things: input devices, output devices, and the interaction language. So the user is interacting with the text editor by giving input and seeing the output from the text editor, and there is an interaction language for communication with the editor. So these are the input devices which we use. First one is text devices, like typewriter, like keyboards. It's used to give the input. Then button or choice devices. So but this example is the function keys. So which if we press a button, it generates an interrupt, causing an invocation of an associated application. Then comes the locator devices. Locator devices, the example is the mouse, which gives a particular coordinate position, which returns the coordinate position of the device. Then voice input devices translate spoken words to their textual equivalent. Output devices. Output devices lets the user view the elements being edited and the result of the editing operations. So it's an output device. Earlier, the typewriters are used that generates output on a paper. Then cathode ray tube, display on screen. Then monitor. These are the output devices. The interaction languages can be of three types: typing or text command oriented, function key oriented, and menu oriented. The user can communicate with the editor using by typing some commands, some text string. So in this case, the user has to remember the commands. Second one is a function keys. So each function key is associated with a particular function. In this, each command is associated with a marked key on the user's keyboard. Then menu-oriented systems. In menu-oriented system, the user is a multiple choice of set of text strings or icons. The user can perform actions by selecting items from the menu. In some systems, there can be main commands in the main menu and have secondary menus also. So the user can select whatever options from the menu. Thank you.